so that we could have wireless mics, and we've got it done over here. I'm gonna explain to you what we did. We with the Behringer, and we hooked it into the back, and all we had to do is they could hook it into the front with a USB cord. This doesn't even have a power cord, so you can just plug it in, start powering up. We have a power button here and a 48 volt light here. Right next to it, we have a direct monitor. What that is if I push that in and we have like more than one mic running, you won't get distortion and messed up sounds and everything coming from two or three different mics going at the same time. It'll keep it regulated. Back here, we have outputs for speakers, but at the moment we don't have the right kind of hookups or right kind of speakers to go with these hookups. We only have the speakers to go to the back of the computer, which is fine with me right now. And we have a spot here for headphones, so that's real good. You hook up your mic here and a mic here. Just to let everybody know too, this isn't just set up for wireless mics. If you are a musician and you play guitar or keyboard, anything of that nature, you can use this for that too. So that's a thought. We got this from a company out of Indiana called Sweetwater. And me and my brother, we did a review on it here recently. So if you want to check that out, you can. They're a really good company. Not only did they send us the Behringer, but they actually sent out like 5 emails asking us if we got our order, and if it showed up on time, it was in good condition. The guy Scott, he even called personally the day after we made the order, and when we did get the package, it came with a small bag full of candy, so we ended up getting some Tootsie Rolls and a couple of peppermints out of the deal. So it's pretty good. They're a pretty good company. So if you're outside of the state of Indiana, it's free shipping and no taxes. And we paid, I think, $19.99 for it. And it ended up showing up in 3 days. We had overnight delivery, pretty much special delivery for free. From this company, so check them out if you guys are interested in it. I think it's a good buy if it works out good and it sounds right. But that's basically the setup of it. Whenever we finished hooking all this up too, all the stuff that was inside of there that needed to be programmed into the computer automatically started, and it finished within 10 minutes. About 10 minutes that it finished, and it was good to go. So I do Minecraft tutorials and walkthroughs. Me and my brother were doing a Robert's gardening experiment where we go through and videotape the garden that we're trying to put together, and we've got a project going to where we're going to be building a greenhouse too soon. So that's one of the reasons why we got this.
Hello everybody, this is Roger, and I'm back again to give you a review of how things are going with my video, audio, setup, and how far we've gotten and what we need to work on. Before I get started, I'd like to say if anybody is watching this video and they wish to give any advice, make any comments to help, feel free to do so. I'm new and doing stuff, so I'm not going to turn away any eager advice that's given to me. At the moment, I'm going through and I'm using OneShare video converters to convert some audio that I have from some things that we did today concerning the garden. We had some water for cannabis that we needed to get today, and went up there with my brother and we made a video of the containers on the back of the truck. So I was wanting to put audio and video together by using the iPad to just record the audio, but the iPad works the same as with the audio as it does with the video. You can't do two things at one time, so you can't play a video and then record the audio off of it on an iPad. Just like I can't use the drum and then use the regular recording settings for the iPad, you know, for the at the same time. Now I can use an app that captures the screen on the app, but the one that we found only did it for 5 minutes. And it's really got bad quality. And it's even worse than what I'm working with right now, so that's one of the issues that I'm having. Like I said, down here is exactly what we're dealing with. I'm not sure if that's showing up or not on the maker. Let me see.
There we go.
It is. That might be good. But I just want to double check, make sure it's working. Got it set up now to where we can have, you know, video and everything on the screen and show you what's going on the computer as well as being able to talk to you in person with the video. I've gotten that far. I've got the wireless mic here hooked up to the Behringer. This is a Bowling. It's not that expensive for the wireless mic, but that's what we got. So we're trying it out. First obstacle that we had with this was trying to record from a distance. Like today, we had it hooked up just like this, and I'm sitting here next to the computer and everything. I've got the iPad there, and then the computer is right over here, and the microphone's on my waist, and right up here on my necktie, and you can hear me. But if I go out the front door in the kitchen, just outside of the truck, then you get static. I'm going to switch to that so you guys can get a sound of what that sounds like because I've got it on here. Let's switch over to it. This is basically what it comes to sound like after we have everything done. I haven't got it too far ahead, you know, you're not really hearing the big part of it. I can't fast forward this, but I can still let it run, I guess. You kind of get the sound of it. Everything that gets pretty static. There's a dip in there. Yeah, I don't think it'll let them pass that way over. But all that static that you hear right there, that's a part of it. That's exactly what it's doing there. I'm pretty sure that it's coming from the Bowling too, because I've listened to other reviews on the Bowling, and a lot of people have mentioned the static. We're gonna put it on the left side, and the other side that goes to the left side. I'm gonna switch back to there, see if it's on. So that's coming from the recording, just so you guys know. That's not coming from the recording. This is with my digging outside. The Behringer and the computer being inside at a distance away. It gets even worse. But we do have some, you know, audio of my brother talking about what he just gotten, so I'm going to go ahead and still use that. I might use it if we come up with something better. But anyhow, we did that. I'm planning on trying to get my old laptop hooked up with the Behringer and, you know, the X-Splitter, if we can get that on there. This computer is old enough that my old laptop is pretty old and it's falling apart, so I don't know if it's going to work with the X-Splitter. It still has Windows Vista on it. That's how old it is, so I don't know. We'll give it a try and see what happens. And then I'm going to take the laptop outside, out back, and see if we can use it out in the backyard when we do our, you know, gardening and everything so that we can have good audio and video. Like I said, I'm using the PlunderShare video converter right now so that I can convert it over to Windows Media Video. And the reason why I'm doing that is because of what I was saying earlier about the audio on the iPad. I can't record a video's audio, just the audio over there, because you can't do two things at one time there. So I'm going to do that, and then I have this right here. I have the old movie MK, the old movie maker right here that was out for the Movie Maker Live. And on this, it's got a pretty cool feature that I like, that I still like, and I don't know why they took it off, but whenever you take a video and you put it on the Movie Maker, it gives you an option of video and audio, or you can just go with audio. And when you take just audio, it gets rid of video altogether, and you can take and put another video right on top of it, right where it was. That's the way I used to take and put my audio and video together. And that's what I'm going to do here after I get that down. I'm pretty sure Windows Movie Maker, WMV, basically. I'm pretty sure it is compatible with the old one. If not, I'm going to try the MP3. I can't remember for sure which one it was, but I'm going to use that on it and switch it around. But that's where I'm at right now.